What is up, y'all? It's the Eric V, your stream teacher. And if you just got a PlayStation 5, congratulations. I know you've waited a long time, but now that you finally got it, you want to stream on Twitch, but you ran out of money. You can't buy a capture card now. I'm going to tell you how to stream to Twitch without using a capture card and without using the PlayStation Twitch application, because that thing is... It works well, but it's a bit limited in the options that you can use. So within OBS, you can have all the mic filters you want. You can use a bunch of plugins. You can get alerts and you can really spice up your stream. So I'm going to teach you exactly how to do that. Now, this method that I'm going to show you doesn't give you a quality picture as much as a capture card would, but it's still more entertaining for your viewers to watch than a direct from console stream without your face on it, or your face that's not like very well lit because your PlayStation Move camera has to be in a certain spot. We bypassing all of that. Let's get into it. Class is in session. All right, so the PS5 remote play app is a little bit more finicky than the Xbox app, unfortunately. But a good thing about it is that you can use this method on Mac as well as Windows. So the first thing you want to do is plug in your PS5 controller directly into your computer. I don't like that step. I like playing wirelessly, but whatever. Now that you've done that, you can find the remote play app. If you don't already have it downloaded, you can find it in the description of this YouTube video. Now, you see I have Windows 11 here, but it works the same on Windows 10. I'm gonna go ahead and open that up. And something that I've noticed, I don't know if it's a Windows 11 thing, or I don't know if it's because I'm not on an Ethernet connection anymore, it's a little bit choppier than I would like. I had to sign in to the same PSN account on my PS5 as I did on the PS remote play app. So make sure you do that. After you do that, it should find your PlayStation on your network. And this is my PlayStation, so I'm gonna go ahead and click on that. And it should find my PlayStation 5. And before I finish my sentence, there it is. So now that we have Spider-Man Miles Morales here, I'm going to click on OBS Studio. And to add that window, you're gonna click on the plus sign and then you'll click on window capture, and you can name this PS5 and click OK. And then you're gonna find remoteplay.exe PS remote play, the same title of the window that you're actually playing the PlayStation on. Another thing about this is that you wanna keep that remote play window as big as possible so that the resolution is as good as possible. And I like to have my windows in about a 16:9, so I don't have to move any black bars around in OBS, but let's just do it at that size. And if you do have any black bars in OBS, you can always use Alt on the border and drag it to get rid of those black bars. But anyway, now that we have that there, for some reason the capture method automatic isn't working right now, so I'm gonna click on Windows 10 and it found the window, and I'm gonna click OK. Now we have the PlayStation 5 in OBS without the use of a capture card. What I always like to do is transform and fit to screen, and I have this video recorded in 1080p60, which I should have did for the Xbox video, but I forgot. So this is recording in 1080p60, so you can see the real true frame rate, and this is being played in performance ray tracing mode, so it should be in 60 FPS. Now, this isn't going to beat a capture card, in my opinion. But what it does beat is you streaming directly to Twitch from your PlayStation without the use of any alerts or any of the bells and whistles that come with OBS or Streamlabs or OBS Live or whatever you use, XSplit. This gives you the option to have more control over your stream, more control over your camera, more control over your audio, because you aren't just talking into a headset. I mean, you can, but you don't you don't have to. And honestly, it's running pretty decently right now. And when I do use remote play, I typically look up at my TV, and this screen is strictly for the audience. So I don't really play from my OBS screen. I'm playing from my TV. So any hiccups that might happen, like that nasty hiccup, which is probably caused from me not using an Ethernet cable. This is why you use an Ethernet cable. My Ethernet cable is too far away right now, so I wasn't able to do it, but you may get little hiccups like that. And honestly, while you see that it's not in 60 FPS, like, I feel like Xbox ran a lot better than this when I did the that video. But even though it's not running in 60 FPS, it is at a playable frame rate. And it's at a viewable frame rate. And I think that's not too bad. But anyway, happy swinging. And that is it. Like I said earlier, mine was a little bit jank, but yours might be better depending on your internet connection. And as long as you're looking at your TV, any type of latency that you might see in the Remote Play app won't affect your gameplay at all. So just try it yourself and you might have better results than I did tonight. Maybe tonight just wasn't a good night for me. I did like 4 recordings of that previous session and I kept running into hiccups. So it's not the best it could be, but again, maybe it's because I have Windows 11 beta or something. So it might work out for you. Try it out. It's free. It only takes a few minutes and you'll see if you can really take your stream to the next level. So if you got any questions, feel free to drop them below. If you want to talk to me on Twitch, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and old school Saturday, I'm there every one of those days. But if you think this video might help somebody out, feel free to send it to them to benefit them and to benefit them strangers. You can hit my video with a like so it can get recommended. But yeah, that's it. Class dismissed. Shout out to EMPTV. By the way, I sound like Alex Jones. By the way, I wanted to say that I won't be on Dead End Gaming this week either because I'll be being interviewed by Mr. EMPTV, so make sure you...